That is the tears of ministry. Ministry didn't begin the day you bought a car. That was not the day ministry began. Not the day somebody gave you and sowed a seed of millions into your life and say, man of God, I connect to the grace you carry. No, that is not the beginning of ministry. Ministry began that very day you lose your child. Ministry began that very day you lose something so precious to you. That is the day your ministry actually begins. The tears of ministry. Let me give you an emphasis. A man called John the Baptist. John the Baptist was killed not because he was a robber, no, but because he spoke the truth. He says, this thing you are doing is not right. It's not good for you to have your brother's wife. And Bible said, the man kept it in his heart. And later, his head was cut. And they brought the head of a prophet in a tray. That was the tears of ministry. The mother was expecting the child to come back home with a car, was expecting John the Baptist to build the house. But behold, the joy was cut short, and his head was just cut and was brought in a tray. The tears of ministry. Let me tell you, ministry demands a painful sacrifice. Don't rush into ministry because you saw someone driving Lexus. Don't run into ministry because you saw people and they are clearing ways for them and they are walking in the red carpet and then you desire ministry. No, beyond that red carpet, there is red sacrifice. Beyond that red carpet, there are red blood here and there. Beyond that red carpet, there are moot cries, there are weepings in the secret places. Tears of ministry. Many families today have been cut asunder. Many today have lost their wife. Many today have lost their husband. Many today have got their business rupted in fire because they accepted to answer the call of divinity. Hey, many we are living very happily. Many we are businessmen and they are successful businessmen and they are doing well and they have their plans. They have their plans and agenda fixed on where to go. Some who do have been in the village by now, if not because of ministry. They are planned to go abroad, but the call of ministry brought them and sat them down in a place where mosquito feed on them every night. Ministry is full of sacrifice. Look at the man called Jesus. He was a boy at the age of 12. He was speaking big grammar. At the age of 12, he was working with professors. At the age of 10, that age, people saw him as being a youth that have a brighter future. But look at how he ended. On the cross, the mother was weeping. On the cross, his friends were crying. On the cross, he was beclouded. On the cross, he wept. On the cross, he cried. But none came to his rescue. Everyone was against him because he was in the school of ministry. Let me tell you, why on the school of ministry? Congratulation is a taboo. On the school of ministry, well done cannot be told you. On the school of ministry, you are on your own. On the school of ministry, there is no room for appreciation. When you do things, you want people to applaud you. They can actually come against you because you are passing through divine making mechanism, divine making attitude, divine making process. Ministry is a divine making process. It's not an enjoyable adventure. We are people carry you on the shoulder and they lift you up. No, ministry is a place where you find yourself. Every person wants to press you down. Everyone is finding fault. Everyone is saying, he didn't talk to me, he didn't greet me. Ministry is an avenue for people to extray you and look for a way to heal you down. Ministry is a place where you have to encourage yourself in the Lord. Bible said before David came down from the school of ministry, the household, everyone has been captivated and they were mighty men cried. Ministry is a thing that makes a mighty man to cry. But hear me clearly. In the school of ministry, there is grace upon the people, upon the students. In the school of ministry, Bible said, God has made all grace abound unto them.
My name is Prona Onyeka. Oh, Onyeka. I'll keep.